And it dies in such brutal ways. It could get Pontard. And the game is over.
Patience is not a virtue I am known to have.
Zara would make a difference there. Yeah. So would have just the Purify. Porphyus, it isn't an investment. It's an investment when you play it. Like when you put it into play. It could be more mulligan fodder, but we're already playing a lot of mulligan fodder. Maybe with Double Eavesdrop we can afford it, but I could see playing one over like a Sea Jackal. Win the game. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yeah, we can get a jackal. I can see that. Your Hyrule, your Kiki warrior? Wait, what? Thing. We'll make a song request with channel points. If you have, I think it's 10,000 channel points, you can request a song from the playlist. Yeah, there's a lot of cards the deck wants to play. I think the problem that I have with Tainted Ale is that it's a card that's only good in your combo round. The deck already has a lot of those. What is this? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. More than this. If I Nero. Salamander? Probably. Should try to get around the scenario. Yeah. I've done that before. I guess I want these carrots. Yeah. Yeah, it was annoying. It means I can't just all in on the Roderick. Experiments are really good.
No, charge!
Yes, I work with Salamander for now.
A superb specimen, truly.
Instead of adding stolen mutagens, I've played it in the past and wasn't a big fan. Matchups? What do you mean? Also, when has that ever stopped me from playing a deck? Isn't it all Nilfgaard? I don't think Nilfgaard's that bad. Seems like there's a lot of play to this matchup.
Nothing will stop us.
I don't really need the coins. Poison versus ball. All the cards that you're trying to self poison purify themselves. You just can't play Abomination early. And there's other reasons to not want to play Abomination early. If you play Abomination early, you're letting them play their Informants and their Brothans early. Usually worth avoiding. Maybe. The problem with the Partners tournaments is they're usually playing at weird times for me. So I do have to play these before I play the Louisa, unless I play a naked Louisa, which seems like nonsense.
Could lift the curse, but who would love such a freak?
Take a peek. So...
Have you heard? I make dreams come true.
Could win this one. I think we do. Thunder be a consideration? It's a consideration, but it's also expensive. Doesn't really help us win round one. I think winning round one is the really hard thing in the Nilfgaard matchup. If you can win round one, you're sort of okay. You're at least playing the game. Yeah, so I'm gonna want to kill the Salamander immediately because he still has his invo. Poison me. Poison one of my things with Cup Air, so I want to remove the poison from my biggest thing. I guess this thing's nice to have. And then we want to kill Abomination. Oh no, if I kill the Abomination, you can purify the Thirsty Dame. I just shouldn't do this. Whoops. Renew and he has leader.
Roma, I'm dizzy with delight.
Okay, so now we go. There's no point in spending here. Yeah, I should have not clicked the hideout, I think. I was thinking that I was going to be able to kill the Abomination before it purified, but that wasn't a thing, and he didn't have Rospace. There's just no reason to do that. He only ended on 2 or 3. No, he only ended on 3, right? Because then he cursed.
You'll join in your blood, onward!
I'm not sure that would have mattered, though. I think I still just lose the last play leader right now. Can you drop one of these to the bottom?
You got a sea beast swimming in them breaches.
Yeah, Carapace is a nightmare. Carapace shuts off Salamander. It doesn't really matter what he's doing with it. On the bright side, it's vampires?
If the ring won't come off, just take the whole finger.
Yikes. Skewed. Do not have my Philippa.
Ah, long ships are over.
Okay, No. Hey, Orphantees.
I knew you were up to something, lol.
Thanks for the prime. Thanks for the 25 months. Yeah. That matchup's a bit of a nightmare. The Serpent Pitfall Blowout was sweet, though. You got me there. I'm just fucked. Whatever. Darn, he didn't forget his beast was growing. My out. Junior, that is one way to kill a beast.
Who is it you believe stands before you? I'm a count, damn it.
Yep. I mean, this can remove some bleeds. That could be relevant. Also, it's just gonna die to Striga. Six, and then the seven. This is so unwinnable. Yeah, like, Salamander's actually worthless. Again. I don't even think there's a way my opponent could misplay it to where a Salamander would do something. I feel very comfortable taking these kicks. Salamander's of fangs. Honestly, that's true. Maybe we should keep it just for that. It's not that insane.
This tech never. Why come to this is powdered sugar?
Maybe we just saw him.
Power, the object of dark desire.
Cool. Let's get our boat back. Honestly, I don't know. Yeah, I should probably do the next turn. Wait, I guess he placed these wrong, right? Now the elders always go off before the Ori. So the Ori is just bad.
Align yourself with the masters of the new order.
I don't let this die. What, I want one coin for Gellert. When Neuromancy is going to get, I guess, the Salamander. Or the Hideout. I tried. I did my best. No tortoise. Yeah, the Elders made it so bleeding the Abominations wasn't even that bad. How do I make Round 1 better? Like, we could not play Philippa. Like, we could theoretically do something crazy like this. Take inspiration from the deck from last night. What's our fitting here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's still pretty short. So I just got this blind pocket. Well, you don't even need the bleed, right? Like, the deck wants last play really badly. Against any deck that has tar removals, you need last play. Distribution is so comically terrible. I mean, it's not that awful. We can get rid of Peaches pretty easily. We don't need that. But, like, all our fives are thinning. Play Nova, you need Renew for the combo. Trying to rely on something like Decoy is nonsense. Marching orders. None of this cards replay Salamander. Create a decoy instead of renew. Yeah, but the decoy version loses to 1 point of damage. Like, it's not really a thing that you can lose to. Not tricky so much as just if you don't have double last play, your combo is garbage. Like, I'm thinning so much that I'm not really playing a lot of 4P cards. Like, what? There's one, two, three golds that just come out of my deck. Two bronzes that come out of my deck. An eavesdrop that puts a bronze on the bottom. I guess I would like to have things to bottom with eavesdrop that aren't just more thinning cards. Marlene. Marlene's nice in round three, but it doesn't help the round one problem. I think I do like Marlene more than I would like something like Stolen Mutagens. No tortoise. I mean, what's the whole poison package? The whole poison package just means you add Roland. I guess you play Bronze Poisons too. I've played lists like that before, and they just seemed too clunky. Ground Blow is definitely not terrible. Why not Scenario to take Ground Blow? Because you don't always draw the Scenario. You can play Scenario and a Neuromancy, but then you're playing Scenario, a Neuromancy, and Renew. And you're just a little too reliant on drawing specific cards round one. Marl's not terrible. My spender situation is a little janky. What can I spend with right now? I have two Street Urchins, AC Jekyll, Gellert Salamander. I wouldn't go Drill Bland. Drill's a pretty cool card. It's a cool way of rewarding you for playing a specific archetype. Can I play Roland with, like, just Gellert and Abominations? It gets me a ton of coins, gives me a backup on Louisa, if that matters at all. Why is Roach 9 Prov? It's a neutral card, comes out of your deck for free. You have more control over it than you do Knickers. That's why this one's cheaper. I don't know, let me try this. I have sort of low expectations.
If it's peace you desire, prepare for war.
Siri deck with no Siri and Renew. Yeah, I mean, Siri Nova is not really the reason to play Siri Nova decks. It's just you have other stuff that you want to do. And fitting in Siri Nova is usually pretty cheap. But here, it's not cheap at all. We literally lose our combo. Approach just 3 points. It's 3 points that don't come from your hand. Where normally you only play 16 cards over the course of a game. Roach lets you get 3 points as a 17th card that comes out of your deck. While also making it easier to draw cards, because it thins. Points that come out of your deck are worth more than points from your hand. Because they do not cost you one of your 16 cards. Start with this.
It's a flower, just take it and a course.
Yes, you! Have you made your offering?
Like in the Unitless Arrakis deck we played last night, it just provided that extra thinning while helping us win round one. In decks that really care about both thinning and getting round one, Roach can make a lot of sense. And sometimes it causes your opponent to misclick and choose the wrong target for their lock.
Shite. Mouse upside down again.
There we go. There we go. We found it.
That is what you folk lack.
It's exactly what Nilfgaard AI would do. Nah, Nilfgaard AI would have turned one double crossed. I mean, this round's going pretty sick. I have no complaints. We're thinning. We're thinning, we're winning. Pass here gets me last play. I don't even know if I want to do that. just play one of these. Double last say is better than last say. Furko for Eavesdrop. It's like thinning two cards. Wait, this is sick. This is sick. You just won on even. We're crushing him. He's a dire mutated hound. So I mean, I could miss renew. I'd be pretty sad. But really want double last say. Vincent kills Roderick. Salamander Abomination. I'll take that too.
Who is it you believe stands before you? I'm a count, damn it.
I like this game. Game sweet. Game sweet. Having a lot of fun with it. You gotta really enjoy games that are like just about a story and don't have a whole lot of gameplay to them, but I'm really enjoying it.
You will not regret this, good sir. The shame I have.
Draw that bandana over your face. It's for the best. Trust me.
Got a little full boat. If he kills Gellert, he kills Gellert. Make an all story. Let's say about good writing. It has good writing. I mean, there's not a whole lot of gameplay to it. You can pick your stats, but I guess you get like a slightly different story based on your stat choice, but I wouldn't really call that much in the way of gameplay.
Let us see.
Nice.
Hey, what's that up your sleeve? Whoever harvests least stays in these woods for good. Got it!
Wee! I don't want to poison you too. Not really.
Why, thank you!
Did I just kill the spies? It frees up space. I can kill the Redinian too. We're definitely killing the Redinian. Pretty sick. I'm glad I added Roland. think he has Vincent. He might, but this didn't really cost us anything.
No one can hide from me.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Oh no, renew. No, McGellert. McGellert. Call me a jester, clown. My used Kikimore warrior. Make sure we're good on row space.
Pay in advance, lover man. No exceptions.
Hey, line tie. Yep, still first disco playthrough.
Focus on it. Quiet the noise in your head. There is no game to be taken lightly.
Figure out my clicking situation next turn. As Veil, right? Oh, I have double essay. I have Roland. And I clicked Louisa, so I believe this game is over. This to this. I guess I can do this for good measure. This deck is broken. Win on even, win the game. He wanted to make sure we had. Being 11 prop. It's just not a card you want to push, because when a card like that's good, every deck just plays it. Pricing it high makes it so you need a specific reason to want to put it in your deck. Pontard. At least if I'm getting Pontard, I'm getting Pontard before he plays a Safecracker. It was good in beta, it's never been good in Homecoming. Like, there's a number of provs where every deck just adds Poet, and that number of provs is sort of hard to identify. but the line between like specific decks that want Poet that would play it and where every deck would play it is kind of hard to find. Yeah, like right now it could probably be like 9 or 10 probs and be fine, but like when they initially printed it and every time they buffed it, the game was in a different spot. It doesn't help that, like, with Thrive, you sort of want those higher provision cards to be bigger Thrive numbers, and Poet doesn't really help you with that.
Can he cut cleanly when you squirt him in a boot like that? You're lucky to keep your heat.
Roach's mulligan costs. Yeah. Roach is more versatile. Roach costs mulligans, though. It has, like, that extra thing to it. Or Poet, when you play a Poet in round 3, drawing a random card from your deck. Usually a little bit worse. But you get to do it in round 3. There's costs to both. There's costs to both. Roach requiring you to play a deck that wants the points round 1 is certainly a big drawback.
Good luck. Not too much, eh?
Yeah, like Poet staples more points onto your round 3 play, but you're drawing cards that you mulligan away. I've seen your hidden line pockets. It exists. No, my boat. My boat. I think I just hope you can't do it. That's not good. These Drill and Philip are gone. It's pretty big. Regard, yeah. And again, you need a double essay thing. But, like, there's no way to get it from blue. Unless he punted and passed into me. Could just not Salamander him. Maybe we just outpoint him. That's rough. I guess we see what's in the eavesdrop and then make the decision.
You feel a draft?
We get the Louisa. It's really not that hard. If their interaction's gone, we can very easily outgreed them. I played some real bad decks that beat line pockets in round 3.
Yes, I work with for now.
Something funky. Okay, let's queue this up. Probably not playing clown. He might have heat wave. Can I bottom the jackal? I guess it was the bottom the jackal. I think I'd rather have the eavesdrop here.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
I mean, am I expecting like heat wave on this? Just try to have multiple failed things. Yeah, I don't know why I didn't pay to the Gellert. Hey, Thomas. If I remove this poison, I have 2 Salamandras, so I still get to click this. the heat wave. Nice. Nice. Kill it. He is my big abomination. He doesn't have any coins to spend. What was my tallest unit? Which is the Louisa, right? I have 12. He has 16. Guerilla Tactics. Some of those decks that can out-engine us.
He venerates not the fire!
In jail. Wait, what? Is that a thing?
Sewers remind me of the fjords back home.
Polo. Okay. We can. Can I still just like roll in Gellert, maybe?
No more half measures. Fill 'em full.
Like, if it doesn't die. This is pretty good.
Draw that bandana over your face. It's good advice. Trust me.
What is happening in my chat?
I admit I lost my temper. Lost it bad.
I guess I'll get this down. I just want to get the engine down. I can play bouncers next. Hey. Ahead. How'd that happen?
Oi,
that up your sleeve.
Chat's being weird tonight.
Let's get this over with.
Somewhat lukewarm here. Enough? I don't actually know. I didn't do the math. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I can get a silver witch ears too. Round for him though. Huh? Yeah, I'm liking Disco. Having a lot of fun with Disco Elysium. Let's can take the dry pass. Indians in there.
Where better to plot than in one's own lair?
Spent 81 prowls in the first round. That's not that much. Drop for the salamander.
You feel a draft?
Okay. So we just get rid of this guy. When's the last time I had Gwent? A couple months ago. I think it's, what, 27? I forget what the context of this was. I don't think we were talking about Gwent. This might have been talking about the artifact reboot, honestly. Trust your ability to add clothes. Yeah, sure. You should have the ability, don't you? Exclamation point, quote, add, I'm pretty sure.
You see? You must hold it to your teeth, like so.
There was an artifact reboot, and then it died. And I think you can say commands or quote remove and then the number. Might benefit greatly from Rayla. Not really. It would be nice if Rayla was a playable card. Rayla's just a little bit too bad. There was no artifact reboot. Oh, there was. They made the artifacts 2.0. I mean, I don't know what you were hoping for.
You hurt my girls, I'll rip your knife off. Is that clear?
Oh, I should have clicked cash, right? Like, no reason to not click cash. I don't have a spender anyway. Yeah, I mean, the original artifact is pretty janky too.
It gets easier, kid. Never enjoyable.
Oh no. I'm pretty sad if he squirrels me, but I don't know, we can beat a Heatwave, I think. It was a little bit like the original artifact. They salvaged what they could.
Go ahead, move around all you want.
Gwent doesn't really live though. Gwent's lived more than like Elder Scrolls Legends. Sharkle certainly lived more than Artifact. Gwent always had that good mix of being both a casual and competitive game. Transition to Homecoming? I mean, that was... There are devs that could have just given up on Gwent after Homecoming. But I'm not surprised they didn't. They put in an effort to improve it. Start on Cachemander Warrior. Nice mulligan, it's whatever. Oh, we have all four of them. Oh. That's a little less whatever. Darn. I knew the double bouncers, I didn't see the double raiders. Yeah, I'm sure there's some passion project going for it, but it wouldn't still be going on if they didn't have players, right? Being a passion project only gets you so far when you're backed by a big studio.
I'll find yourself with the masters of the
placement's dumb. Placement is actually just actively bad. There's no reason to place like this. I'm losing a soul point here.
If the ring won't come off, just take the whole finger.
Yuck. bricks. My kicks were just Salamander, Louisa, Roach. Okay. That's a problem. Yeah, don't underestimate Skellige's reach. I guess I think I just play one of these thinnings.
Knees are drowning in shite, but the head's in the clouds.
It's a little weird. He was also playing a Gerd though. Bloodthirst engine. Why don't they ice me early? I thought this deck just stomped AQ. Didn't need to play Gerd.
Remember, there's a reality secret.
I thought that was the appeal of the deck. Sure.
Up and at 'em, you lazy bastards! You'll sleep when you're dead.
Okay. Yep. There's a bit more of a cost to Saul needing to manage your coins. Like, an 8 revision Saul is better than an 8 revision Dire Mutated Hound, sure, but Saul's just a better card to be pushed. It's a more interesting card. I'd rather have Saul C play than Dire Mutated Hound C play. This is sad.
All that dancing around. It's not for me.
Oh. always gonna last the ice, and we can't ever beat that. But there's a lot of ways you can play this to make us lose.
Double the kind and consider it done.
Shuffle tracks. Oh, it should be order random, right? I think the way shuffle works is like when I went back to hydrogen, I put the rest of the stuff in the same order. Maybe. Yeah, we're super dead. We are super dead. Salamander. Are you a time traveler? Are you from right after Salamander got released? Surely he doesn't have 11 points. No one's ever had 11 points before. Gonna poison off the hound. And the second poison still kills the hound.